touching on this last weekend, there was a lot of spring games throughout college football. Now we've kind of seen spring for the most part wrap up. But there was one that was, let's just say, more hyped than others. I think you know the one I'm talking about. How about Deion Sanders and the Colorado Buffaloes, Coach Prime, selling out his first spring game? Now, the weather didn't cooperate, but I got to tell you, I was all in. ESPN was all in. I loved it. Chris Fowler, by the way, who's a Colorado alum, he was there. Robert Griffin III, Quinn Kesnick. They did a great job. I was watching that thing. I kept looking at my boys and my wife, Sarah, and I was like, hey, look at this. It's sold out. Look at it. Look how amazing this is. And they were tweeting it out, Colorado, from their account, pictures, you know, sell out, 47,277 in attendance.
How you doing? Do you have a good Easter?
How you doing? Hey, great. Like that. Welcome.
Thank you. This is my grandma.
Okay.
Yeah, you know.
Good on you. Please look at you. You already ready, ain't you? You got on your...
You know how it goes.
I see.
All right, so we're going to jump you up in the front part of the trailer so you can meet her.
Hold on. You're going to do what?
We're going to get you in the trailer.
No, you're talking real fast. Just slow that thing down. ease it in. Yeah, Ralphie's been kicking, huh?
You're good. All right, she's right here. Come here, sweetie. Yeah, this is Coach Prime.
Mm-hmm.
You can have a good
favorite
ball together.
Food in the world right here.
Okay.
Makes us some corn and some grain.
Okay.
She loves to eat it out of your hand.
Come here,
baby. But you got to be careful. Because if you don't hold your fingers right, she'll try and chomp them right off.
Thank you for that.
Come here, baby.
So appreciate that. That's the end of that experiment.
Yeah.
She'll grab you with your tongue right there.
You want to give it a go?
I need gloves.
Yeah, you take the gloves.
I'm not doing that for just...
Yeah, you got to be careful. She'll get some slobber on you.
See, every time you say careful, that
you... Well, it just, you know...
...did something that nobody would have predicted. Coach Prime has already radically changed the culture in Boulder, but it's not just the culture in the locker room. We'll get to all of that in just a moment, but we've told you guys about what Coach Prime and the Coach Prime effect has done in the transfer portal. You guys know that Coach Prime and the Buffaloes pulled in the number one transfer portal class in the country. And you guys have seen what he's doing on the recruiting trail. Now,
people are saying Deion's overextending here and he shouldn't be doing this. What do you think about what Deion's doing?
I think people are freaking out about it. He literally said this was going to happen.
Okay, he said it's going to happen, but that doesn't... That saying it's going to happen and making it cool that it happened are two different things. Now, I'm not saying it's cool or uncool that it happened, but I had 21 players enter the transfer portal. So they went through a spring practice, and it is clear that now that you see guys coming out and tweeting this and saying these things, that Deion is encouraging these guys to get in the portal. He's clearing the deck. He is changing the roster. He is changing everything about Colorado football. He's shipping one group out and shipping another group in. They started with 85 scholarship players to begin the season last year. 65 of those are gone. A lot of people don't like it. A lot of people are saying Deion's overextending here and he shouldn't be doing this. What do you think about what Deion's doing?
I think people are freaking out about it. He literally said this was going to happen.
Okay, he said it's going to happen, but that doesn't... That saying it's going to happen and making it cool that it happened are two different things. Now, I'm not saying it's cool or uncool that it happened, but I had 21 players enter the transfer portal. So they went through a spring practice, and it is clear that now that you see guys coming out and tweeting this and...
A few moments later.
Third down, Morris. Intercepted. Wow! Travis Hunter. Unbelievable. Hunter just plucks it out of the air. Finds Travis Hunter. Hunter looking for the first down, picks his way forward and gets close. Operating out of the gun, Sanders looking wide open, touchdown, Dylan Edwards.
What you get is a confusion here between the linebacker and the end, and Colorado just exploits it by getting the back out there. So
now Colorado with it, first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Shedeur Sanders fires to the far side. Has Shedeur Sanders takes a knee, and how about this? Prime time, Deion. Here in Boulder, and we've got an old school rivalry for you as the Nebraska Cornhuskers out of the Big Ten come into town to take on Coach Prime. And loose ball, who's got it? And Colorado says they do. Arden Walker with the fumble recovery.
The ball, and that's exactly what Colorado.
Shedeur Sanders to the sideline. What a throw. Woo! Travis Hunter with the catch. Trick play here. Dawson, can he get there? Touchdown, Colorado. Tarvarish Dawson, his second score of the day.
Here, he's going to fake the little shovel pass first, then the option, and then he flips it to Dawson, who's got lead blockers in front of him. Beautiful move and a great block out in front.
And I sat down with ESPN today, and I don't care if they hear it in Boulder. I told them I took my hat off and I took my glasses off, and I said, when I talk to grown-ups, I take my hat and my glasses off. That's what my mother taught. So
Colorado win by 80 tonight? Me too. No, I hope they just beat them. Beat the dog. I want them to beat the dog. Out of Coach Joel Neal, whatever his name is, that dude is a straight-up clown. That football coach for Colorado State, he's a straight-up clown. Wherever he coach at, I don't even want to give the school no shine now. Because how you going to say that your mama taught? Why would you bring mamas in? What's up with these mama jokes? That man got to endure so much hate and disrespect, it don't even make no sense. When have you ever seen somebody make Norvell? When have you ever seen somebody make a mama joke to a football coach? Oh, my mama taught me to take my hat and my glasses off to talk to somebody. And nigga, he was just doing an interview with his hat on. Like, he got to be a dummy to think that nobody wasn't gonna go back and check to see if you ever did an interview with a hat on or some shades on. And that clown was sitting there with a visor on doing the interview. So maybe your mama didn't teach you what she thought she taught you. Since you want to bring mama jokes, when all we trying to do is see y'all play a good, exciting football game. That dude a clown for that.
The ranked team in USC, they got a big date with USC coming. Let them take us for granted. That's what he should have done. Let's go in here and shock the world. You guys want attention? You guys want your just due? You guys want people to pay attention to you and say you're good?
Let's go. It's all right.
The 22, they ruled it a sack. Picked off! Real estate ahead! Shiloh Sanders showing him his shoe bottoms!
Say Blackburn received some 7,000 threats. Their detectives spent more than 100 hours reviewing all of them. Well, now.
Now, this hit definitely was a little late,
but that doesn't mean the kid should be worried about his safety.
We needed this so bad in this moment. Amazing stuff, and this just proves what type of character this guy has. You just love to see it.
Guys, the fans of this show, the comment below on what was said. Man, what a game tonight. What a game. I know some things were said before this game, but what a game. Here it is. Trying to read lips. You see his son there, man. That's a good son. That's a good son right there, man. He's like, he wanted to deck that dude.
No, I know Shador kind of got in between it. But no, I don't. Man, I don't hold. You know, I could be petty if they petty, but I ain't got time for that, man. I'm on to bigger things. I'm happy for the brother. I really am, man. I'm happy that they fought, that they played a good game. I'm happy he's a head coach. I'm happy for any brother that's doing it and successful, man. I truly am. I don't know where all this stuff come from. I have to respond because, you know, it's my mama taught me that. You know, you just ain't gonna take me and I'm gonna sit back and ain't gonna say nothing. But I'm happy for that dude, man. I don't know him, but I'm happy for him. I wish the best for him. I really do. Nothing, my success ain't got nothing to do with his. So why would I want him to succeed? I don't know how people get down like that. My blessings ain't got nothing to do with this and run with this. Henry Blackburn is a good player who played a phenomenal game. He made a tremendous hit on Travis on the sideline. You could call it dirty. You could call it he was just playing the game of football. But whatever it was, it does not constitute that he should be receiving death threats. This is still a young man trying to make it in life, a guy that's trying to live his dream and hopefully graduate with honors or degree, committed to excellence and go to the NFL. He does not deserve a death threat over a game. At the end of the day, this is a game. Someone must win, someone must lose. Everybody continues their life the next day. Very unfortunate. I'm saddened. If there's any of our fans that's on the other side of those threats, I would hope and pray not. But that kid was just playing the best of his ability. And he made a mistake. So I forgive him. See you. Our team forgive him. Travis is, he's forgiven him. Let's move on. But that kid does not deserve
getting it. Death threats. Henry Blackburn is Prime. He has spoke up. We are all listening. Joy, what's your reaction to Prime's response?
This is what he should have said. What are we talking about here? This is a game. And that's what he said. Yeah. They're playing a game. These are young people. Can't call them children because I'm sure he's of age. These are young people playing a game. Was it a bad hit? Do most of us feel it was a dirty hit? Yes. Does that mean that someone should kill him?
No.
I mean, what are we talking about? This is the right thing to do. Just take the heat off of the situation. Obviously, we're all very upset. I'm sure Travis Hunter is upset. I'm sure his teammates are upset. I'm sure Deion's upset at what happened. I'm sure Henry Blackburn is upset about how he handled it now that everything has happened the way that it has. But listen, I've gotten death threats before. I don't know if anyone else up here has. It's quite unpleasant. It's very unnerving. And this is a young person who's playing a game. What, do you don't think that's going to be in the back of his head now every time he steps on the field about how he is going to approach a situation. It's really unfortunate. I'm glad Deion said something. I know Deion's voice carries a lot of weight. And if it was a fan of the team, you know, that this is, it's just unserious.
The more, like, when I went back and just looked at the video right before I got on, I was thinking, like, nah, it just seemed a little cowardly. It did seem cowardly because it's like, bro, like, if you're going to go hit somebody, like, it almost would have been, I would have understood it more if you would have just, like, ran in there reckless, boom, you know what I'm saying? But he kind of slowed down, and then the ball hit the ground, and he took a couple steps and then hit him. So it just seemed a little bit more calculated. But long story short, nobody needs to be receiving death threats.
CSU football player Hunter White. The spotlight was on CSU and CSU on Saturday night. Both teams fought to the finish in double overtime. CU won 43-35, but the team celebrated without receiver Travis Hunter. He was taken down by CSU safety Henry Blackburn. Blackburn and the Rams were given a 15-yard penalty for After that, then he left again and was taken to a hospital. Now today we learned Hunter suffered a lacerated liver and he'll be out for 3 weeks. And fans, they are furious. Tori Mason joining us in studio. And Tori, Blackburn and his family now getting death threats.
Yeah, people have gone as far as posting his parents' phone number and addresses on the internet. They've been getting threatening messages and calls. Now, that hit got a lot of people riled up, but no matter what you think of it, the reaction shouldn't be more harm.
It was a hit seen around the nation.
Travis Henry of, I think that's what it was, of Colorado is out for 3 weeks after a violent hit by Colorado State's defensive back, Henry Blackburn. Now, with that being said, the defensive back for Colorado State has been receiving death threats after that hit and after Travis was out. So this is a very big deal. This could result in a lot of people getting into a lot of trouble. It looks really bad. If it is from the Colorado guys, it looks really bad on the university, on the program, everything. I'll keep you up to date on everything that goes on with this. I'll put the link in the description below. Please let me know what you guys think of this. Let's get into this. Let's have a great conversation. Until next time, guys, I'll talk to you.
Sliman, you have the opportunity and you have the grace of starting in college football, and one of your skill players gets hit and hurt like that in an egregious way, it is absolutely your responsibility to go over there and talk some massive shit. Now, do it in a way where maybe you don't get a penalty, but if all five of you can lock in that dude up in a cage where he can't really get out and you're fucking talking shit, getting on him, where the refs have to come and pull you guys off, but you're not shoving and pushing, so there's still no flags, so you're playing smart ball, but you fucking go over there and be like, in that dude's face, say whatever. You can just yell. You can literally just yell. That's what you need from your offensive lineman. That's the thing I did not like about that play, where I would be in that team meeting room the next day being like, you guys f-ing see this? Like, how come our quarterback's the only one going up in this guy's face? It should be all f-ing 105 of us out there on the field where they got to separate us. Yeah. Take three.
It's Sean Lewis, the offensive coordinator, moment ago, downfield, incomplete, but a flag down intended for Hunter, who took a shot afterwards by Henry Blackburn. And now some words, Shedeur Sanders coming to the aid of his number one target there.
Play this week. We need to get everything we can so I can get back on the field. I'm not taking no for an answer. Who you think sent me that? How did you know that? Because what? No, you ain't ready, and I care about you more than I care about this game. You're going to change the game of football one day when you're healthy and ready. Your future is brighter than mine ever will be and ever was. Relax and get healthy. I love you, son. That was the conversation. I care about y'all more than I care about this game. But I want you to learn throughout this game and throughout trials and tribulations who you are.
Ken Henry Blackburn put on CU's two-way star Travis Hunter in the Rocky Mountain Showdown back in September. Well, that sideline hit touched off a firestorm of reaction, but now Fort Collins police say one adult and four juveniles face charges for... Hunter suffered a lacerated liver and missed some games because of the hit, but never seemed to hold a grudge against Blackburn. As a matter of fact, you can see the two even went bowling together not too long after.
How we doing?
Good. Go ahead and let the people know who you is.
You know, Blackburn. You know, play at CSU. We just played last weekend or last Saturday. You know, just making sure he's good, checking in with him. I know we talked after the game on the phone and then through the DMs and stuff. And
made this happen for the people that love to see negativity. This ain't a negative video, man. This great positive, and you know how we get. I feel like if that didn't happen, we wouldn't be here right now. So it's a blessing that happened. Yeah. So now we can show people the other side of football. Like, football is just a game at the end of the day, and we're the people that play it. So. We're going to get hurt eventually. You just can't look at it as negative. It's something that's good coming out of it, like right now. This video is something good. Us coming together is something good that came out of that injury or that football game. So,
Henry Blackburn, you know, play at CSU. You know, I was just making sure my guy's straight.
I feel like if that didn't happen, we wouldn't be here right now. So it's a blessing that happened. Yeah. So now we can show people the other side of football. Like. Yeah.
Just to clear things up, I never meant to hurt you. You know how it goes.
Bro, it doesn't matter if you did or not. It's football at the end of the day, man.
What's up with you?
What up?
How we doing?
Good. Go ahead and let the people know who you is. You know?
No, you don't need to hammer home a player. A player knows. I mean, he could fool himself and trick himself, but when he looks at the mirror, he knows what he's looking at. Something like this is I'm not going to say, you know, people around the country would say this is what they needed to humble themselves. We wasn't arrogant or whatever. We're confident people. If our confidence offends your insecurity, that's a problem with you. It's not us. We expect to do well. We expect to play well. We expect to win every game we step out there. We expect to practice to perfection and go out there and execute the things that we practice. We just didn't do it today. But it's not something that was needed. It's just like saying you get in a car wreck or something. Oh, he needed that to slow him down. You don't need that. That's just stupid. It's just something that happened, and they got the best of us today.
Every possible shred of motivation in order to beat them is the foundation of sports. And Dion and his team have talked Colorado, Oregon. It was an utter beatdown. It was such a beatdown that the story coming out of this game was that Dan Lanning was somehow engaging in racist behavior by beating Colorado. This is crazy. Wanting to beat... think that there is something improper about the way Oregon and Dan Lanning conducted themselves, you really need to get outside of the racial prism. And this is, to me, one of the dangerous parts about turning sports into identity politics. Imagine what the reaction would have been if Jay Norvell was white and he had said that about Deion Sanders and wearing baseball caps and wearing sunglasses or whatever. There's possibility that Jay Norvell would have gotten fired in the wake of the hit that happened on Travis. You guys think I'm crazy. If he was a white,
takes his time, lofts one in Sanders. The air, caught, takes touch. His time, lofts one in the air, caught, touchdown Colorado.
Steps up in the pocket, runs it, gets a first down and more. Sanders sprinting to the end zone, touchdown Colorado. Hankerson looking, dives, touchdown. On second down,
Shedeur Sanders finds Harrison. Touchdown, Colorado. 21 yards across the field. Fourth down and five. Sanders sprints out of the pocket. Looking. Touchdown, Omarion Miller. Wow. This kid's electric. Xavier Weaver, terrific receivers. Here's Sanders. End zone. Jimmy Hoare.
Passing situations with his receiving ability out of the backfield.
Sanders underneath, complete. In space, nice move. Hunter, Travis Hunter! Touchdown! T-12!
Catch, that huge catch you just made that we just showed, that third down catch on the goal line. Looked like incredible battling going on. What happened on that play?
I just had a lot of confidence in myself. I told my coach, third down, give me the ball. We're going to win this game. We're going to get up out of here. And I did what I had to do. Catch the ball, get a touchdown, and let's go.
A freaking hit on this touchdown right here. I know I was getting hit, tried to ball up and turn away, but it's too late. Took a hit, knocked the wind out of me, hit me right in the ribs. They kind of picked me up. Nah, couldn't pick me up. I had to walk off under my own power. You know, Coach Prime, if you can walk, you ain't hurt, so get off the field.
That's what I did.
But that hit hurt, but I know I had to catch the ball no matter what. Nobody cared how hard I got hit. As long as I caught the ball, that's all that mattered. That shot right there hurt worse than my freaking cheap shot.
Real? Shedeur Sanders from my HBCU?
Absolutely.
The one that played at Jackson last year?
The one that played at Jackson State last year.
The one that you asked me, why would I give him the starting job? But like, not you. I got receipts. I know who they are. Not you, baby. I just got to say it. I would never.
I believe Colorado is going to go to the playoff with Deion Sanders at some point. I know that sounds insane, and there's people probably laughing, but it's like, I believe it. Look at who he's recruiting. Look at the landscape of where we're going with the 12-team playoff. I think he's good. I mean, TCU just went to the national championship in a 4-team playoff. I believe Colorado is going to go to the playoff with Deion Sanders at some point.
Delusional group of players and coaches and that group that resides out in Boulder, Colorado.
Shedeur is a great quarterback. We talked about this yesterday. Sacked 52 times, still had 27 touchdowns and only 3 interceptions. You might be undefeated in the SWAC. You're 1-8 in the Pac-12. And I do think it was must-see TV last year. It was so much fun in September. They lost 7 of their final 8 games. You are not the Super Bowl. I think you might be the Super Bowl for the simple fact that teams hate you because of what you believe you are, and they want to beat you into oblivion like Oregon did last year. But I don't get the Colorado hype, and I don't have a big expectation for this team. The win total's 5.5 in Vegas. I think it goes under, and I don't know. I think they're going to be okay.
Doesn't intersect Hall of Famer Deion Sanders.
This game taught me so much about people.
This will always be my house. Now let's continue.